ان الذين امنوا والذين هادوا والنصارى والصابئين من امن بالله واليوم الاخر وعمل صالحا فلهم اجرهم عند ربهم ولا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. Verily all those who believed, that is who became Muslims, who believed in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, والذين هادوا, and those who became Jews, والنصارى, and the Christians, والصابئين, and the Sabis. This was a different nation, and most people think they were in Iraq, and they thought they were following Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Some say they were the people of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam. They were following the Sharia of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam. Wallahu alam. Nothing is known for sure. The real thing is, man amana billahi wal yawmil akhir wa amila salihan. Whosoever believes in Allah, has real faith in Allah and the day of judgment, the last day, wa amila salihan, and then he does or he did good deeds, for lahum ajruhum inda rabbihim, for their reward is now with their Rabb, with their master. It is assured, their reward is assured with their master, with their Rabb. Wala khawfun alayhim wala hum yahzanun, and there shall be no fear upon them, and nor shall they be grieved. Now this ayah is a very controversial ayah of the Quran. Some people have inferred from this ayah that having faith in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not essential for salvation. Because here also you note that Iman bil Akhirah and Iman billah, only two basic articles of Iman have been mentioned. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ هَادُوا وَالنَّصَارَى وَالصَّابِينَ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَلَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. But actually it's a big mistake to argue in that way. Because here you refer to the section number 7, section number 6 of this very surah. This whole discussion starts with an invitation to the Jews to believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So it is as if you know, in arithmetic you know, there is some sum which is outside the brackets. And it is multiplied by all the quantities that are within the brackets. Here actually this whole discussion is governed. It will be at every moment, at every place, it will be multiplied by the contents of those 7 ayat which came in the beginning. That is why you know there is a very close similarity between this bracket, the word I am using. Because the two ayat with which this discussion has now started, Ya Bani Israel Askuru Ni'mati Allati An'amtu Alaykum Wa Anni Faddaltukum Ala Al-Alamin Wa Attaqu Yawman La Tajzi Nafsun An Nafsin Shayya Wa La Yuqbalu Minha Shafa'atun Wa La Yukhadu Minha Adlun Wa La Hum Yunsarun. The same two ayat will come in the beginning of section 15. Ya Bani Israel Askuru Ni'mati Allati An'amtu Alaykum Wa Anni Faddaltukum Ala Al-Alamin. The same two ayat. What does it mean? The bracket starts with these two ayat and brackets end with those two ayat. And before this bracket are the 7 ayat of section 6. And you know the main theme of that section is وَآمِنُوا بِمَا أَنزَلْتُ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا مَعَكُمْ وَلَا تَكُونُوا أَوَّلَ كَافِرٍ بِهِ وَلَا تَشْتَرُوا بِآيَاتِي ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا وَإِيَّايَ فَاتَّقُونِ. يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ اذْكُرُوا نِعْمَتِيَ الَّتِي أَنْعَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَأَوْفُوا بِعَهْدِي أُوفِ بِعَهْدِكُمْ وَإِيَّايَ فَارْهَبُونِ. So basic subject is the call to the Jews to believe in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Quran. Now that common factor has been taken outside the bracket. It is not being repeated everywhere now, but it is governing the whole passage, the whole address, you know, that is commanding, and that is governing the whole passage, and that is actually the meaning. Now if we gaze our eyes and fix our gaze on this ayat, what does it mean? It means that at the time of every ummah, there was a time when Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not born. Up till that time, the ummah was Nasara. Whosoever Christian at that time believed in Allah and the Akhirah and did good deeds, well, his reward is assured with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is safe, he will get the reward. Before Hazrat Masih alayhi salatu wasalam, It was the days of the prophethood and messengerhood of Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Any Jew who actually believed in Allah and Yawmi Akhirah, and he was going with this, then his reward is also assured. So actually this pertains to the periods of every ummah, that from every ummah, only belonging to an ummah is not decisive in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because you are a Jew, even in the days before Hazrat Masih alayhi salam, if there was a Jew, if he was not doing good deeds, if he didn't have real belief in Allah, well, his deeds were meaningless in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he had no position. Even for the Muslims today, if we only profess to believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is the era of Muhammad now, after the advent of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, everybody has to believe in him. But only believing in him doesn't mean anything. Unless we really believe in Allah, unless we really believe in the day of judgment, unless we really believe in the hereafter, unless our good deeds are there, and they are just, you know, rationally proportional to our beliefs and our professions, then actually, unless these things are there, being a Muslim, being counted a Muslim in this world, doesn't mean anything on the day of judgment.